The following is an exclusive presentation of Raycom Sports and Lincoln Financial Sports.
Tonight, from Florida's capital city of Tallahassee, it's ACC basketball from the Donald L. Tucker Civic Center. The Maryland Terrapins are in town to battle the homestanding Seminoles of Florida State University. And a key matchup is up front for the Maryland Terrapins. 6'8 junior James Gist is coming in off a career-high 26 last week against the Georgia Tech Yellow Jackets. He went 10 of 11 from the floor against Tech that night. And for Florida State, Al Thornton continues to be the pace setter in the ACC, averaging over 22 a game in conference play and torched the Deacons for 25 and 11 boards here last weekend. It's Al Thornton and the Seminoles against James Gist and the Maryland Terrapins. When we come back, the rest of the lineups and the opening tip from Tallahassee after this.
You're watching ESPN Full Court, presented by Olivia High Definition Television. For more info, log on to olivia.com.
Monday.
You can't stop.
Super Tuesday.
Up in the air. Oh, my goodness.
ACC Wednesday.
The Dokies are on fire.
All season long, beginning Monday at 8 on ESPN.
I want you up. Are you watching? We're about 8 points away from being undefeated.
We don't want nothing from nobody.
These guys involved.
We got this thing.
There's no one in the country that wants to play you.
God, do you see us?
We've got to compete.
ESPN Classic has fans talking.
It's more than just great games.
They got all kind of great new shows.
Gotta be ringside.
Ringside.
Ringside. Boxing's unbelievable.
Who's number one?
Our countdown of teams, athletes.
Let the debating begin.
Top five reasons you can't blame.
From the forgettable to the unforgettable.
I'm stuck to the TV all day.
ESPN Classic. Take another look.
That's classic.
Unbelievable!
Oh, you gotta love it.
Here you go, sweetie.
Chocolate pudding, please.
We don't have any.
What is with these people?
I don't know, Duke boy.
We're on campus. College game day, driven by State Farm. Saturdays, 11 a.m. and 8 p.m. Eastern, only on ESPN.
ACC basketball is being brought to you by Chick-fil-A, by Ford, by Food Lion, by Alltel, by Advance Auto Parts, by Pepsi, by Geico, and by Budweiser.
Back inside the Civic Center here in Tallahassee, the Food Lion starting lineups tonight. We talked about Gist in the open. Ed Beckway leads them in rebounding. And for Florida State, Al Thornton joined by Uche Etufu up front, Isaiah Swan, Tony Douglas, and Jason Rich in a three-guard look in their backcourt. Big game, no doubt about that. Despite the fact that both clubs have losing ACC records today, Maryland's 2-4, Florida State 3-4 overall. Billy Packer, these clubs are having outstanding seasons.
Well, we're almost into the month of February, Bob, and you have one team 27th in the RPI and Florida State 29th. Maryland 27th, Florida State 29th. I realize they're not going to win the conference championship, either one of these teams, but both of these teams are capable, with a run in February and early March, of being NCAA tournament teams and being effective, because they've proven throughout the course of this year that they can beat good basketball teams.
And these are two teams that have been out of the tournament. Florida State, for quite some time, Maryland's missed the last two seasons. They want to get back in March. Opening tip to the visitors. And Vasquez is fouled out front by Tony Douglas. Let's check the four keys to the game.
Well, the stats will really strike you in this one. Of course, containing Thornton, three-season number two guy, is the ACC Player of the Year. There's a good tap-in, by the way. Guest already off to a good start. And, of course, one of the things that really is difference between these two clubs, in assist-turnover ratio, Florida State's 11th in the ACC. Maryland is second in assists. So treasuring the ball could be important in this one.
After the miss by Douglas, a foul underneath. And this will go against Ebekwe. The Terrapins are forcing over 18 turnovers a game. Three ball out of the corner, rebounded by Maryland's Mike Jones. Ahead to Gist. And he misses the jam. Rebound Thornton.
Did not concentration put that shot away. Made a beautiful crossover move for a big man on the run. And didn't concentrate on the finish.
Yes, bothered that shot. And it's out of bounds to the Seminoles. Gist has 51 blocks this season coming in. Was number 5 in the ACC in that category last year.
Maryland once again being an outstanding shot blocking club. You've got Deshaun Williams out of the league. Gist has an opportunity to move up even further. And he and Ebekwe could be 1-2 before the season is over.
Jason Rich got the bucket. Now Strawberry misses. Gist high for it, out of bounds, Florida State ball. The Seminoles have lost only one home game this year, and that was to Clemson. They're 12-1 in this building. The men of Leonard Hamilton have won three consecutive games in ACC play here at home, the latest being Wake Forest.
And included in one of those games, of course, is that win against Florida, who most people would say is the best team in the country.
That was back in early December, 70-66.
Great pump fake.
This is Rich, and that's a three-pointer.
The extra pass was made twice, Bob, but I thought that Rich had an opportunity on that first jump shot to get a better look than the one he eventually made.
Nice cut to the bucket, and the pass was right there for Ebekwe.
Thornton on a hedge move got caught way out of position.
Douglas drops it into the post and a travel. So Etchefu with the extra step. Let's take a look at what happened at the other end.
Excellent bounce pass. Ebekwe gets away from Thornton, who went out on the hedge move and didn't recover quickly enough.
5-4 Florida State. Vasquez cross court to Jones. His three ball, no good. Ebekwe back up and in.
Bob, we're seeing some terrific offensive rebounding by Maryland early in this ball game, beating Florida State to the basket.
Terps up one. Isaiah Swan drives it and scores it.
Isaiah Swan.
I ought to point out in regard to Florida State, they basically are even in rebounds with their opponents. They do not have an advantage this year, so Maryland ought to be able to take advantage on the glass.
Ebekwe losing the basketball, 3-on-2 the other way. Douglas, the fake and fire. Long board secured by Swan.
Both teams kind of getting what they want on the offensive end of the floor.
Thornton will drive it and kick. Rich in and out. Thornton lost the handle, and that triggers a Maryland running game. Little ball fake, and Jones scores it.
Nice patience by Jones on that fast break. I thought he'd pull up and look for his jump shot, but normally he does not take the ball all the way to the hoop.
Defense! Tony Douglas. Over to Thornton. He'll try a three and hit it.
Now there's where he is so tough to guard. You know, he can step out of Beckway. Probably has an opportunity to stay with him down in the low box, but when he steps out there, not many big guys in the league can go out with him.
Jones inside, a Beckway had it blocked. Florida State the other way, now Thornton, pull up.
Etchefu.
And a jam follow for Etchefu. Wow.
A block on one end and a jam not being blocked out on the other. Good job.
12-8 Florida State. Vasquez to Jones on the curl. Swan. Guides it over to Douglas on the bounce.
Beautiful.
Gets it back, and the lane is good.
Some really nice passing by Florida State so far early in this ball game.
And Gary Williams takes a timeout. 15:36 first half, and like that, Florida State has put 14 points on the board. We'll return after this message from Florida State University.
Thank you, no, Florida.
Here you go, sweetie.
Chocolate pudding, please.
We don't have any.
What is with these people? I don't know, Duke boy.
We're on campus. College game day, driven by State Farm. Saturdays, 11 a.m. and 8 p.m. Eastern, only on ESPN.
Nothing is impossible. It's a dirty word, a challenge dismissed with a rip and a shred. Gravity
took away what looked like was going to be an easy basket. Etchefu really hustled down the floor. Nobody blocking him out here. He comes right down the lane and puts it back in.
Etchefu, the sophomore, averaging 7.5 and 4 boards a game. And Maryland finds itself down 6. Three-pointer. Open look for Gist.
Florida State twice now has had problems with a hedge move getting caught with two men on one, leaving a big man for Maryland wide open. Gist could have just as easily rolled to the basket and got even a closer shot.
Number 11, Gerald Allen is in. Ralph Mims as well, number 10, handling it. And we've got an illegal screen up front called against Ryan Reed. And with that, a timeout. 15:04 first half, 14-11 Seminole.
Classics. Sunday, Jack Nicklaus, Tiger Woods, Carl Spackler.
It's in the hole!
See Chevy Chase.
Stop thinking, let things happen, and be the ball.
Bill Murray.
Gunga Galunga.
Rodney Dangerfield.
Let's go while we're young!
And the Gopher, starring Caddyshack. Real Classics, 8 p.m. Sunday on ESPN Classic.
14-11, Florida State leads Maryland early. We welcome you to ACC basketball. Bob Rathbun, Billy Packer with you. You mentioned it early, Billy, a couple of ball clubs that have been away from the NCAAs for a few years want to get back in, so a very big one tonight here in Tallahassee.
Absolutely, and, you know, the head-to-head situations. Last year they only played one time against each other, Florida State winning here. This year they will play two games, but, you know, there's going to be such a separation. You know, with North Carolina playing so well in the ACC, get Duke next week, so it'll be interesting to see whether they can stay with them. But so many teams in the league between that second spot and maybe the seventh spot, you can shake them up in a bag. And so here's one of those games, you shake them in a bag, somebody's going to come out with a huge win tonight in regard to getting themselves in a position closer to the NCAA than maybe they would have been before this game.
Jones off the glass and good.
Second time tonight that Jones has scored inside, unlike his normal game where he is a great perimeter shooter.
And both teams shooting well.
I see a really lack of defensive intensity early in this ball game, though. Most of the people are getting exactly what they want. Another example.
Going to the hole is Al Thornton. He's got five and a free throw to come. Nice lead pass.
Terrific pass in this respect, Bob. Watch how he sat down to get that pass inside to Thornton. Thornton held his ground, kept his defender on his hip, but everything is happening much too easily on both ends of the floor. The defensive intensity is just not there.
Thornton, an outstanding free throw shooter, 85% overall, 89% in conference games.
And number four in the league in free throw shooting percentage. Among all the other things, he's way up near the top.
Having a terrific year. Vasquez, Strawberry, Gist. Inside Osby, and now a foul.
Again, the ball going inside much too easily. Now, Maryland is asking for there to be a basket there because the Florida State player grabbed the rim and pulled it down. But the ball has to be on the rim in that particular case. It had no chance to go in, so no way it was basket interference. Watch this right here. See, the rim comes down, but the ball was long outside the cylinder before that took place.
And that's the explanation that Gary is getting from Curtis Shaw.
And he's shaking his head and going back in the other direction.
Vasquez, a good free throw shooter too, 82%.
First time today, Maryland picking up. 1-2-1-1, full court pressure. Drop back to their man-to-man.
17-15.
Gist on Thornton.
Turnover.
Good pass, though.
With a whistle, and I believe the clock was stopped. And it should not have been. But we've seen that all too often this season.
Well, let's not get into the shot clock situation or we'll be talking about that episode at Duke, which was probably the all-timer that I've seen in this league in a long, long time. And certainly very difficult for Clemson. You had them again with another difficult loss. And they start talking about teams, RPI, NCAA tournament bids, and things of that nature. Look at Clemson is a matter of seconds and a shot away from winning two very important conference games. Instead, they find themselves with two losses.
The Virginia comeback was as remarkable a comeback as we've seen. My thoughts immediately went back to the Duke Carolina game when North Carolina, behind Walter Davis, erased that 8-point deficit 17
yeah.
seconds. Virginia was 14 down with 3:40 left.
I was sitting under the basket at that game when that comeback took place. I was sent down on the floor to interview Neil McGahee, who was the coach at Duke. People don't remember that. To interview him for this great win he was going to have, and I watched that 18 seconds right in front of me. It was just unbelievable.
Chris Redding couldn't get the ball in. Tate Armstrong missed a big free throw, and that probably cost Neil his job.
That's a possibility. But there was no way that North Carolina could get that game into overtime. Looking at the clock right now to try to determine exactly how many seconds should be up there. There was 25 seconds when they blew the whistle. Now they show 27 on the clock.
Yeah, It just seems to me that there's a better way to do this.
Well, one of the things that I think the Duke game has something to do with the amount of time it's taken to figure out the number of seconds here. That one, I was watching that game at home, and I actually couldn't believe it. And, you know, I'm going to give a lot of credit to Oliver Purnell in regard to how he handled himself under those circumstances. But, you know, I could just as easily have seen a coach say, I'll tell you what I'm going to do, ref. I'm keeping my team right over here on the bench. And when you get this thing straightened out, I'll bring them back out. Otherwise, I'm taking them to the locker room. But the man showed an awful lot of class. I tip my hat to him in that respect.
So the shot clock was running, but the game clock was not. And that's what the discussion is at the table, how much time to take off. Join the Mania ACC fans. You could win up to $100,000 plus hundreds of other great prizes. The winner all tells My Circle Mania Sweepstakes. Text HOOPS to 84353 or visit MyCircleMania.com. And now we're back to the action. Maryland Hayes, basketball.
Hayes and Vasquez, the two freshman guards out there now for the first time. Turnover.
And a loose ball at midcourt. And that's going to be a foul on Eric Hayes.
Allen did a real good job defensively out here, hawking the ball. First time we've seen some real pressure on the ball defensively.
Allen triggers and a quick three from Mims in and out. And the rebound is going to be a held ball. The arrow gives it to Florida State.
Entering the Florida State lineup, number 15, Casella.
Pretty nice run here by Florida State, taking Thornton out of the game with a two-point lead. You know, one of the things you think about minutes played by some of these top players, what Jared Dudley's doing up at Boston College, playing almost 39 minutes a game. And the next four guys in the league in regard to minutes played all play for NC State. Don't see many subs there. Foul.
On the attempt by Gerald Allen. Strawberry with the personal.
You know, when you take a look, Bob, we talked about this, Maryland number one in the conference in regard to field goal percentage defense. But so far in this ball game, Florida State's been kind of getting the shots that they want.
Some of the numbers just don't add up. You figure Maryland with that low field goal percentage defensive number, then Virginia goes over 100 against them.
Well, and here you have a situation in regard to Florida State. They're shooting on the year 48%, almost 49%. Maryland holding opponents down to 37. So something's got to give in a ball game like this. And so far, what I see, Florida State getting the advantage. They're getting good shots, good looks at the basket. Even with Thornton sitting on the bench right now.
Way kicks it back out. Vasquez picked up by Hayes, and his three-pointer is good.
Well, that's an assist that was not intended to go to Hayes. Took advantage of it.
And getting the three-pointer right back is Breeden. That's just the second three he's hit in conference play.
He's only shooting 27% from three on the year, but there was no hesitancy whatsoever. But again, he was wide open for the shot.
Foul, offense. Offensive foul indeed.
And I'll tell you, when he puts a shoulder and an elbow into somebody as he did right there, it was so obvious that it was an offensive foul, but that's got to hurt. Young man is very powerful. Matter of fact, it's so funny. Breeden is down there laughing with the referee about what it felt like to take that elbow in the chest. He won't be shooting any jump shots for the next few minutes.
James Gist back in for the Terps. 12-10, first half. Here's Swan.
Very difficult shot, left-hander. Not squared up on that shot.
And they travel. Timeout with 11:59 to go in the first half. Florida State leading Maryland by four.
The Golden Globe winner for Best Drama is Grey's Anatomy.
George has become a sex machine.
And this Thursday.
You yelled at me for no reason, and now you show up here.
With temperatures on the rise.
Anyone seen Callie? I kind of need to find her for something.
Somebody's bound to get burned.
When you get a minute, I'd like to talk about the kissing.
Callie!
And nothing compares to the last 5 minutes, where three of the season's biggest shockers are revealed.
Okay.
An all-new Grey's Anatomy, Thursday at 9, 8 Central, followed by an all-new Men in Trees, only on ABC.
Every Saturday night at 8, Classic Ringside.
I shook up the world!
Studio hosts Brian Kenny, Bert Sugar, and boxing experts reveal the real story behind the greatest fights.
Down goes Frazier!
And fighters of all time.
We are going to do this one more time.
Next up, Mike Tyson, the Kid Dynamite years.
Tyson didn't know anything. He was Roy, he was crude, but he was strong as hell.
Classic Ringside, 8 p.m. Saturday, only on ESPN Classic.
Huskers.
No.
Huskers with a Z? No. Ooh, a husk guy.
Take him.
How about with that heart? Hus, heart, cur, no. Brasky guy, brasky pants, brasky man. Bet nobody's...
Nope.
Somebody's got that. You know what, I need to go write some more and I'll be back. Oh, wait. Excuse me. How about Nebraska? Sorry, dude. Nebraska.
Maryland inside with James Gifts and Kenny Ebekwe. They're getting some production inside tonight. And Billy, these are two guys that are veterans in this league who know their way around that rim.
They really do. Maryland started off the ball game. That first tap in by Gifts was the first play of the ball game. You can see the numbers, and something jumps out at me in this ball game right away. Both teams shooting well over 50%. Maryland's win over Virginia Tech this year, they shot 58% in the first half. Right now they're shooting 58% so far in this first half. Getting some easy looks. Thornton back in the ball game. So that matchup, Thornton-Gist, will still be fun to watch.
Good catch by Ebekwe.
Maryland's been able to get their way inside, having trouble out on the perimeter. Thornton had good position. The ball didn't go to him.
He's got Ebekwe on his hip, drives it, and lays it in.
Ebekwe just accepted the offensive position that Thornton was going to take. There was no way he'd stop him. You can't play a player of his magnitude that soft.
Ebekwe saves it. And another open look in the corner for Maryland. And Hayes has another one.
Right from the same spot. Twice now, he's gotten kind of an errant pass for a wide open look.
Maryland back within one. Rich over to Douglas. Swan thought about it. Now Thornton off the dribble. And out of bounds. The Terrapins have a chance to take the lead.
Thornton really has that pump fake. He takes his eyes, really looks up. Pumps strong with the ball, and most people respecting his ability to hit that outside shot have to go for the fake, and then he gets that extra dribble by.
Terps have hit five straight, looking to take the lead. Nice in rhythm jump shot by Gist.
All it is a little pick and roll and a glide to the outside by Gist. Florida State doing a bad job defending that play.
And head coach Leonard Hamilton will call a timeout to talk about it. 10:34 to go in the first half. And a 25-24 lead for the visitors. Timeout on the floor, and as the teams discuss strategy, you should too. Get someone to talk with you, not at you. Talk to Chuck Charles Schwab. Well, Leonard Hamilton very animated in that Florida State huddle.
Well, you know, Bob, if you take a look at that play, it was just a simple pick and roll and in a screen from the outside, and he is very upset in regard to his big people. Every time they've hedged so far in this game, they just stay outside and don't drop back with the men. Watch right here. It's a little hedge. Look at, you got two men on one. The switch does not take place. The original guy guarding the ball just kind of fades away, and so those are wide open shots.
And you have to respect the Maryland outside shooting. They lead the league in three-point shooting.
Well, you'd rather give a guy an outside jumper from 22 feet than let him just roll down to the basket and get easy shots from 12 or in some cases from 2 feet from the basket. That little pick and roll has been defended very poorly so far by Florida State.
Douglas, now the bounce down. Thornton, as Hayes drops back to double. Terps recover defensively, now Etchefield.
So when that ball goes into Thornton and they double down, the shooter should be ready to take the shot. Great hands.
Thornton fading off balance, it goes.
Ow.
10 already.
One of the things that makes him such an outstanding player is that he can catch the ball even in traffic with some power. That was an outstanding fadeaway shot, but what made it was the ability to catch the ball in traffic.
And Beckway rainbows it up and off. Rebound claimed by Jason Rich.
Not many guards can get up in traffic like Rich did there to get that rebound.
Deep three for Isaiah Swan. Florida State by four.
That play made by a guard that with a tremendous effort on the defensive rebound.
Jones firing and missing.
Bad shot.
Take a look at Thornton again.
And I talk about the ability to catch the ball in traffic. Ball goes inside. See, it's very difficult. He grabbed that ball with his left hand, still had the power to bring it back down in shooting position and then make the turnaround jumper. An awful lot of players would have probably lost the ball on the catch, much less had an opportunity to bring it back down and shoot. That's what makes him one of the premier players in the country.
Douglas. Etchefu. And a poor hand check.
Bowers.
It's on Will Bowers, his first. In Winston-Salem, Georgia Tech and Wake Forest tonight. Georgia Tech was up by two, trying to break a long road losing streak. They dropped 16 straight on the road. Swan's jumper is good again.
And you saw another score up there of a team that has been very disappointing this year is Syracuse. Notre Dame, a team that probably has played better than anticipated.
Vasquez all the way through, gets a layup.
Vasquez made a name for himself right off the bat with that tremendous performance at Illinois, where he basically looked like a star senior performer, much less a freshman just getting battle tested in a ACC Big Ten matchup.
Came off the bench to put home 17 in that game, and a travel on Thornton.
Entering the lineup from Maryland, number 23, Mike Jones.
Here's the handoff, and here comes Vasquez.
And look at that defense. Very, very poor by Florida State.
You mentioned that win, Billy, at Illinois from Maryland. They haven't won a road game since. That one coming in late November, ending Illinois' 51-game non-conference home winning streak. Guest inside. And a push against Ryan Reed.
Well, if you look at this game quickly, what Maryland ought to be doing is to get the ball down inside. They've had their way anytime they get it down inside. Gist, I don't know about Bowers inside, but Gist gets anything he wants inside. There he is again. Maryland has gotten away from that. If you're Florida State, Thornton has been able to have his way with Gist, and now that Gist is off to a good offensive start, you want to get Thornton the ball more often, maybe get Gist in some foul trouble. But the Florida State doesn't spend a lot of time getting the ball directly to Thornton. He has to get it in the flow of the game.
Swan, feeling it.
And a four-pointer.
That's 10 for Isaiah. And the free throw to come.
Official timeout.
A Timeout in Tallahassee, 7:43 first half. The foul on Jones will put Swan on the line when we come back.
Jimmy?
Steve?
Get in my face! Get in my face!
Bold, brash, and brazen.
Shut up!
They are Madden gamers, the best of the best.
You want a ball! You want a ball!
This elite group hit the road battling each other for the right to stay on the bus.
Let's go, baby!
But in the end, it's the last two standing who will play for $100,000 on the big screen in Times Square. Madden Nation, ESPN2.
This is the legend of Muhammad Ali.
Oh my goodness, it's Muhammad Ali.
Float like a butterfly.
Sting like a bee.
Now available.
I've done something special.
Bring home the greatest on DVD.
I'm a world figure.
I am from the House of Shock.
His life.
Who's the top of the world?
His legend.
History will be written.
His words.
That alternative is justice.
I am America.
I am the greatest.
I'm the champion of the world.
Ali Rapp. DVD and book available now.
Get ready to get the games you can't see on TV. Introducing ACCSelect.com, the new way to see your sport.
Isaiah Swan taking the shot, a 35% three-point shooter. Beautiful follow-through on that shot. Squares up. Remember the one time he wasn't squared up on the jumper and missed it, but there he hits the three and gets fouled. 0-5. Wake Forest, remember that? Downey had an opportunity to win the game for Wake Forest. Wake had made 50 free throws in a row. He has a chance to win the game with a four-point play. Misses the free throw, breaks the streak. Florida State eventually wins the game. Swan now with a chance for a four-point play. And he's got it.
The 11 points overall for the Germantown, Maryland junior.
You know, it's amazing, Bob. You sensed early in the ball game the defense intensity was not there. You know what these two teams are shooting? You have a situation, Maryland shooting 63%, Florida State 62%. You know, so that's not surprising to me. Both are shooting over 50% from the three-point line.
And another bucket for Vasquez. 35-31. Coming up on the 7-minute mark here in the first half.
Again, nobody looking particularly for Thornton. There he is.
Up in the air, in the bottom of the sack.
Boy, you've got a go-to man. The answer is, you know, if you're going to make two or three passes in a half-court set, he's got to touch it once.
Now Vasquez to Strawberry.
Again, just driving down the middle, nobody helping out. This game is being played without defense.
Just putting it in on the follow, 37-33. Swan being defended by Parrish Brown. The pull up, no good for Douglas. And the rebound to Strawberry. Strawberry for three. That's good.
I have never seen so many wide open looks in a half-court game, 37-36. Both teams shooting over 60%, getting any kind of shot they want. A Strawberry has been a great defender in his career. But there's a Case Douglas.
Maryland foul number two, P.J. Strawberry, his second, team's eight.
Let's take a look at our Q Motor Oil Power 25, the weekly rankings. North Carolina now number three. Was such an impressive win at Arizona last weekend.
It was unbelievable. When Brandon Wright and Ginyard were both, we were told before that game started that they would be sitting out the game. I'm thinking, my gosh, it's a 9 a.m. Eastern time ball game, you know, for the guys. They had flown out the night before. You've got two key players and Frazier sitting down. So basically you got three starters that are not going to play in the game. Very difficult environment. It turned out to be the biggest loss in Lute Olson's history at the University of Arizona. Just a tremendous display by North Carolina. I'm in a way, considering that national exposure they got, I'm surprised maybe that Wisconsin jumped them in the rankings this week. But it'll be very interesting. Wisconsin's got some big games coming up with Ohio State. Big game coming up with Ohio State. And that's a club that does not give you many open looks like we're seeing here tonight in this ball game.
Florida State perfect at the line. Two more for Rich. He's got seven. 39-36.
Again, Beckway. Whatever you want inside for Maryland, whatever you want outside for Florida State. Balls are passed to whomever you want to pass it to. And look at that. No weak side help. Easy catch. Layup. You know, it's a time maybe that you think, well, maybe we're given an effort if you're a coach sitting on the sideline. Maybe we're given effort and man-to-man we're not matching up well. As an example, when you take a look at Douglas, Rich, and Swan, three very powerful guys in the perimeter for Florida State. Maybe it's a time to try some zone, change a little defensive strategy to see if you can shut somebody down for a minute or two. 39-38, all you're looking for is some breathing room.
Wake now by six. And that Georgia Tech Yellow Jacket team is reeling.
Youth that has never really turned it around. And here's Gary going to a little bit of half-court trap.
Near steal by Gist.
Nice dribble, but a bad pass. Breeden had a pretty good idea, though. Came out here, hit a jumper earlier in this ball game. And that ball just was thrown away, but he showed me something in the fact that he did see the play.
39-38. So Maryland, despite its defensive deficiencies, oh, that's a push off. Vasquez the foul. Maryland had a chance to recapture the lead in that possession.
Vasquez looking back at Gary Williams said, I know what I was doing. I thought I had the play, and the young man might have been right. It was a pretty good flop. And here you see picking up. See if they stay in a little bit of a half-court trap.
Whoa, a loose ball.
Boy, with the turnover problems that Florida State has had, you'd think Maryland would try to maybe stay in a trap like that, get them to start turning the ball over a little bit.
Breeden drives it. Etufu, and knocked away. Strawberry back for Maryland. Paris Brown goes out. This broadcast is a copyrighted presentation, and the use of it without the express permission of Raycom, Lincoln Financial Sports, and the ACC is prohibited. Bob Rathbun, Billy Packard, our crew from Tallahassee. Glad to have you with us. An interesting one, to say the least, 39-38. Swan buried in the corner. Etufu, Lutzenfly, a three-pointer.
Etufu and Breeden, they're both hit from the outside.
Strawberry missed the three. Beckway had it poked out of his hands. Now Thornton back in.
Breeden sits down. Kind of interesting to watch that young man. I realize he threw the one ball away. He's made a jump shot. He made a good pass in his last drive.
Hayes is open. At your food boards. Now coming up is Ralph Mims.
Mims, way to go.
That's a charge.
Did job by Vasquez getting in the way. Mims had no place to go on that play. Again, Thornton comes back into the ball game. No patience shown by Florida State to say, hey, we've got a guy they haven't proven they can stop yet.
That no one has proven that they can stop.
It's certainly not in big games. And this is a big game for both of these teams.
Gist.
Has he even been challenged inside?
42-40. Batted down. Etufu fends off the man. Gets the ball back. Near steal by Gist. Now Mims at midcourt. Swan going inside. Turnaround is good for Jason Rich, who's got 9.
And that was against Strawberry. Rich has got great elevation, very powerful young man.
Eric Hayes, nice find. Abekwe wrapped his arm around the defender for an offensive foul. And that brings us to a timeout. Abekwe's second, 3:13. Remaining in the first half, our 25th anniversary season of bringing you the best in the ACC. Maryland and Florida State separated by 4 at this timeout.
In sports, you always got to bring out your A game, especially when you play CNET Sports, powered by ESPN.
Oh, yeah, this one's mine. This one's mine.
This is a DVD board game hosted by Dan Patrick. It has tons of trivia questions.
The Rocket. Dwayne Wade.
Nine.
No!
And clips from every major sport.
That's immaculate reception.
But with us, you just don't want to come in last.
CNET Sports, powered by ESPN. The ultimate DVD game for the ultimate sports fan. Have you seen it?
It's not okay.
Introducing the new X Games inspired Moto X bike, built for performance, 20-inch BMX dual suspension, front and rear disc brakes, and Moto X styled saddle and fenders. The X Games Moto X bike, ride Moto X style.
Coverage of the UEFA Champions League only on ESPN Deportes.
Okay, guys. Touchdown, Chad Johnson, and?
And old school. A little bit of
pop and lock. Booyah! Ha! Boo-no. Next.
Sizzling bacon action.
No.
Touchdown, Chad Johnson.
I like it. But can I get a puff of smoke with that?
We can do smoke.
That was good.
We're back in Tallahassee, and Al Thornton just continues to impress.
Well, Bob, we talk about players that have good stats, but what I really like about this young guy is in the big games is when he has the stats. North Carolina, 29 points, 12 rebounds. Florida, 28 points, 9 rebounds. Virginia Tech, 27 points, 13 rebounds. I mean, it's one thing to pile up stats against the weaker teams. This guy does it against outstanding competition.
How did he go scoreless in the first half against Virginia Tech? I can see how he scored 27 against the Hokies in the second half.
Well, you know, I did not see the game. But in watching this game, one of the ways that that can happen is that your teammates don't realize who you are. And if you have a guy like Thornton on your team, you want to make sure he's getting the touches, because he's going to deliver. He's not a selfish player. Here's Maryland for the first time going zone. This is something I anticipated that one of these two coaches would do to see if he could slow down the wide open shots. 2-3 zone now by Maryland.
Loping in, and Douglas hits a tough runner.
Again, Douglas and Rich Two terrific athletes on the perimeter. And Swan not bad himself.
A lot of firepower on this Florida State team. Vasquez. Good protection of the ball, and he got the lay-in.
Vasquez and Hayes are both a good 6'3". Vasquez maybe even a little bigger than that and plays bigger with those long arms. Not afraid to take it in traffic. Maryland went zone just for one time down the floor.
Etchefu trying to draw a foul.
And should have gotten the call. He got fouled on a shot without question. Bowers hit him.
Vasquez. Gist. And Bowers pushed by Etchefu. Let's take a look at our Chick-fil-A nuggets of the game, and it has to do with the ACC RPI rankings. And Billy, this is the point you were touching on earlier, Maryland 27, FSU 29.
And you figure, anybody in that 30 range, Boston College there, and I realize with Sean Williams out, that's going to alter their team, but I still think that they're a solid NCAA tournament team. Not going to be the ACC leader, however, but still a solid team. So ACC very well represented. Why would you, if you're Etchefu, foul a man like Bowers who's coming to meet the ball down inside? He's not going to make that play on you.
Vasquez misses the three. Gist knocks it out of bounds. Florida State has it. I think one of the big challenges for Boston College is in midseason learning how to play without Williams right in the middle of the conference schedule.
Well, remember Gary Williams had that problem a year ago in regard to his guard position.
46-42. Oh, so and that is going to be a hold on Maryland.
Well, the passing by Florida State has been excellent. We talked about the turnover situation for them, but look at how easy that pass was. It's like a playground pass. Rich inside, and we've seen how he can explode both on the offensive and defensive end in regard to rebounding. That time he just exploded the basket on the offensive end.
Rich, an outstanding free throw shooter. He's made 14 in a row, counting his two earlier today, and 82% for the campaign.
Well, that's one of the things about this team. They're number one in the ACC, number three in the nation in regard to free throw shooting at 78%. Something you look for. You start talking about teams, the little fine difference between being an NCAA tournament team and not. There will be those games coming down the stretch in February that it gets tight. Can you make those free throws a la Clemson, which is having just the opposite effect? Where would they be as a team if they were shooting 78% as a team from the line? Just think about it.
Yeah. Now, Curtis Shaw asking Florida State to come back out onto the court. They've got the clock situation taken care of. There was a question as to the foul, and it was charged, I believe, to Mike Jones.
Mike Jones been very quiet in this first half. Took one bad shot from down in the corner. Has not been a factor in the game at all, but certainly from a defensive standpoint that time, Rich was wide open right on the box.
There is nothing like college basketball, and if you're celebrating the win, do it right. The way you celebrate says a lot about you and reflects on your school, so be responsible. Take care of yourself and your friends. A message from Anheuser-Busch. Been a nice recovery for Florida State. They began the league season 0-3. A win tonight gets them back 4-4 at the halfway mark. Leading 5 with a minute 17 left in the half. Gist pushed.
Seems like every time that Maryland will take the time to go inside, they either get fouled or get a nice looking shot for Gist or a Beckway.
James Gist to the free throw line for the first time tonight as Parrish Brown comes in for Strawberry.
Gist on the year already with 5 double-doubles. And as you mentioned at the top of the show, 10 for 11 against Georgia Tech, 26 big points the other day.
72% at the line. Gist is a sophomore in a victory over Florida State, 11-7 with four blocks in 31 minutes. He has another big night cooking against the Noles. He's got 15.
Now you have Bowers on Thornton, even though Maryland a zone trapping defense. Gist gets back on and makes the switch. Good move by Maryland. Bowers is not going to handle Thornton.
Swan and a foul inside.
Was that Rich on a? Yeah. Rich on the inside move, trying to get that low post position again. He's going to go down and talk to the official, runs all the way down the floor. But he gets caught down inside, wrapping his man around.
Vasquez, another lay-in. Half a minute to go before halftime.
Leonard Hamilton down on one of the floor, just shaking his head. Gary Williams down the other hand, shaking their head. This is almost going to be a 50-50 type halftime. Both teams on course to potentially hit 100. And it's all been the lack of defensive intensity, which started off, you got a feel for it right at the beginning of this game.
Shot clock at 7. The pull-up is good.
Another easy shot.
Douglas with 6. Maryland coming quickly. 2. Vasquez from midcourt. Just off the mark. And we've reached the half at Tallahassee. First team to 100 wins. We're at the half here at Tallahassee. Florida State 49 and the Maryland Terrapins 46.
ACC basketball is being brought to you by Toyota, by Progress Energy, by Pontiac, by Chick-fil-A, by Gatorade, by Chevrolet, and by Ruby Tuesday.
Generation of players who are driven by one thing, the desire to win. Now that Wade's Heat have a title, will LeBron's Cavs be next? Can the Suns prove that offense wins championships? Will the Clippers turn LA from purple and gold to blue and red? Watch the stories unfold all season long on ESPN.
So, have you been on a lot of blind dates?
Well, this would make one.
Oh, yeah. Me too. What do you do?
I'm a vet.
I love animals.
Really?
Yeah.
Where are you from?
Michigan, born and raised. Go Blue!
Go Buckeyes!
We'll be right back.
Conference, a tradition of excellence. Then, now, and always.
This is my dream.
My dream to be the best in the classroom and in competition.
I will celebrate my victories and learn from my defeats.
I will succeed.
I will achieve my dream.
I am a student athlete in the Atlantic Coast Conference.
The official corporate partners of the ACC salute all the student athletes as they pursue their dreams today, tomorrow, and beyond.
Ruby Tuesday presents the Play of the Week.
Marshall has it out deep. 2-1, gets it away at the buzzer. It's good! And Boston College wins it! Marshall with the three-pointer for the left wing at the buzzer! And Boston College wins it 85-82! Wow!
49-46 halftime. Florida State leading the Maryland Terrapins. Bob Rathman back with you here in Tallahassee. Let's bring you up to date with what's happening. One other big ACC game tonight. We check our Bud Light scoreboard. First up, Winston-Salem. The Deacons up 11 on Georgia Tech at halftime. Kyle Visser with 15 for the Deacs at the break. Ole Miss on top of Mississippi State, 81-66 in the second half. There's that Syracuse-Notre Dame matchup Billy was talking about, 97-84 and a score-a-thon there. Also tonight, Oklahoma in a non-conference game having its way with Longwood, as you would expect. Baylor with the early lead on Colorado tonight. UNLV, Locke Kruger has done a remarkable job. That club back in the national rankings as well. And they're at Colorado State tonight. And that is our Bud Light scoreboard. The last shot of the first half for Florida State. This bucket by Tony Douglas, giving the Noles a three-point lead.
Here you go, sweetie.
Chocolate pudding, please.
We don't have any.
What is with these people? I don't know, Duke boy.
We're on campus. College game day, driven by State Farm. Saturdays, 11 a.m. and 8 p.m. Eastern, only on ESPN.
Nothing is impossible. It's a dirty word, a challenge dismissed with a rip and a shred. Gravity is my slave. I don't get air, I take it. I drop jaws, I shake boots, I destroy pipes. I collect precious metals. I don't just land tricks.
No way!
I invent them. Winter X Games 11, it only happens here. January 25th through the 28th, live on ESPN and ABC.
Whether your sport is football, baseball, basketball, it's always a great time of year to be a fan. The easiest way to support your team and find the coolest gear around is online at ESPNShop.com. From clothes to cleats and everything in between, you want it, we've got it. Go to ESPNShop.com to get your gear today or call 1-800-762-1701 for a free catalog.
Wednesday, February 7th, Lost returns at a brand new time, 10, 9 Central.
Go now!
I can't!
Keep running!
Everything you've wanted. 16 new episodes. Everything you've waited for. No repeats. Is coming.
No matter what I try to do, you're gonna die.
Lost returns with a new episode every week beginning February 7th at 10, 9 Central. Only on ABC.
At 6-1, North Carolina half a game back at 5-1. There's BC at 6-2, and you see the significance in this Florida State Maryland matchup tomorrow night. Miami, North Carolina, Chapel Hill. NC State goes to Virginia Tech, and on Thursday, Duke at Virginia. We'll be back with more. Billy Packer rejoins me. We'll talk about this first half. The freshman Vasquez had double figures in the first half.
Huskers.
No.
Huskers with a Z? No. Ooh, a husk guy.
Take him.
How about with that heart? Hus, heart, cur. No. Brasky guy, brasky pants, brasky man. Bet nobody's.
Nope.
Somebody's got that. You know what? I need to go write some more, and I'll be back. Oh, wait. Excuse me. How about Nebraska? Sorry, dude. Nebraska.
MVP signed a one-year contract with the Giants. You've probably heard the process of negotiating this contract was complex, lengthy, and highly unconventional. This decision was not taken lightly, and we spent significant time evaluating all the elements and circumstances surrounding the negotiations before we made a final determination to move forward. Of particular concern, this is where you need to pay attention, of particular concern were the allegations against Barry in the New York Daily News on January 12th. Now, again, they didn't write anything about the allegations, I guess because we all know what the allegations were. Anyway, goes on. We consider any action by one player to unfairly damage the reputation of another player to be a serious matter. Based on the information that we have at hand in this matter and in discussions with both players, all of the facts... when we found out Barry Bonds tested positive for? Well, what do you think he tested positive for? Ah, you thought it was for steroids. You forgot it was for amphetamines. For amphetamines. And that was when Barry Bonds sold out Mark Sweeney.
My relationship with Mark Sweeney is phenomenal. We have a great relationship. We're very good friends. All that was false. Everything there is false. Mark Sweeney never did anything wrong, period.
Did you ever bring his name up?
No.
All right. The New York Daily News is yet to be sued by Barry Bonds. He just said all of that is false. Peter McGowan goes on. Additionally, we felt that these measures, signing Barry to a one-year contract, helped us pursue a long-term strategy towards getting the club back on track. With his presence in our lineup and only a one-year contractual commitment, we'll be able to avoid the temptation to trade away some of our valuable young pitching talent. We're able to free up long-range
moment in ACC basketball history, which has been presented by Geico. Three-point Florida State lead here at halftime over the Maryland Terrapins. Bob Rathbun, Billy Packer back with you. This league's been around a long time, partner. I'll tell you, I can't remember the last time in a conference game where both teams shot well over 60% from the ball.
You know, Bob, it's funny. You go to a lot of basketball games, and you get a sense right off the game sometimes. Sometimes there's great defensive intensity. Sometimes it's lacking. In this particular ball game, it jumped out at me right away at the start of the game. When guys are getting wide open, easy looks, comfortable jump shots, easy passes to the interior, you're going to shoot well if you get that easy a shot, and then you start gaining your cover. Look at this jump shot. Not a man within 10 feet of the shooter. Here we'll see a pass down inside, a dribble down inside. Nobody coming over to help. Vasquez goes right in, uncontested for a layup. Down the other end of the floor. Low post position, defender out of position, no help from the weak side. Thornton just puts it away easily. Again, Rich goes right up over the top. Nobody drops down from the outside to double him up. The defender right at his back, and look at those shooting percentages. Now, you know, it's one thing if somebody's just playing, having the game of their life, but in this particular case, both teams have been able to get any kind of shot they want, basically unguarded.
Interesting to see what the coaches decide to do about that and with their halftime adjustments. And speaking of halftime, it's coming to an end. Second half straight ahead when we return after this.
In sports, you always got to bring out your A game, especially when you play CNET Sports, powered by ESPN.
Oh, yeah, this one's mine.
This is a DVD board game hosted by Dan Patrick. It has tons of trivia questions.
The Rocket. Dwayne Wade.
Nine.
No!
And clips from every major sport.
That's immaculate reception.
But with us, you just don't want to come in last.
CNET Sports, powered by ESPN. The ultimate DVD game for the ultimate sports fan. Have you seen it?
It's not okay.
Introducing the new X Games inspired Moto X bike. Built for performance, 20-inch BMX dual suspension, front and rear disc brakes, and Moto X styled saddle and fenders. The X Games Moto X bike. Ride Moto X style.
Coverage of the UEFA Champions League only on ESPN Deportes.
Okay, guys. Touchdown, Chad Johnson, and...
And old school. A little bit of
pop and lock. Booyah! Ha! Boo-no. Next.
Sizzling bacon action.
No.
Touchdown, Chad Johnson.
I like it. But can I get a puff of smoke with that?
We can do smoke.
That was good.
ACC basketball is brought to you by RBC Centura, by your Carolina Chrysler dealers, by Sonic Drive-Ins, by Charles Schwab, by Q Motor Oil, and by Red Lobster.
Start of the second half. The Wackos here at Tallahassee. Oh, they love that camera. James Gist has 15 to lead Maryland. Travis Vasquez has 10. And for the Florida State Seminoles, the big man, of course, is Al Thornton. And he scored 12 in... We would have to say, Billy, limited touches. He only had 7 shots in the first half.
7 shots, very few touches beyond that. I bet you he didn't touch the ball 12 times in the first half. And more importantly, the guy guarding him was Gist. Gist had 15 points for Maryland, and he's guarding Thornton. If you're Florida State, you want to get the ball to Thornton, try to get Gist in some foul trouble, at least make him put a bunch of effort into what he has to do on the other end of the floor.
Strawberry bumped as he shot, and the personal on Jason Rich is his second.
First aggressive move by Strawberry in this ball game. He is normally a shutdown defender, did not get it done in the first half, but he really didn't have any specific guy to guard. So you have to have, I think if Maryland's going to come back in this ball game, Strawberry is going to have to do the job, and Mike Jones, who was extremely quiet in that first half, he's kind of a feast or famine player, going to have to pick it up.
Strawberry missing the first of two. He's Maryland's leading scorer at 15.2 per game. Hit just a three-pointer in that first half. Missed them both. Jones battling for it. He was the last to touch, I believe. Yes, Florida State ball.
Strawberry just a 71% free throw shooter. If you're Gary Williams, those are two free throws you wanted right away. You want to get your team moving here. Picks up again, little half-court situation. Great block!
Oh, Beckway took it right off Thornton's hands.
Two-handed block catch.
Jones missing. Etchefu rebound, ahead to Rich. Rich drive, shoots. Beckway took a swat at it, but didn't get it.
Juan, Rich, and Douglas. Three built low to the ground, powerful players that can explode.
In the paint, Ebekwe, short.
Second ball. Good play by Etchefu. I think Thornton, he walked.
And he gets the score.
He walked and got by with it.
14 for Al Thornton.
I think he wanted to make a statement from that last block, however. He took that one hard to the hole. He's got a look of determination on his face right now.
53-46. And the foul coming on Etchefu. Check out Ebekwe here.
This is some block. He gets it with one hand and catches it. And then Thornton says, no, I'm coming right back at you. I thought he walked on the play. Guessed again, a nice soft touch.
Is he on a roll? 7 of 8 tonight. 10 of 11 in the last game against Georgia Tech.
They've taken Gist off Thornton. They've got Ebekwe now guarding him.
5-point spread.
I watched Thornton from that distance in halftime and warm-ups, and he made about 8 jumpers in a row.
Swan gets his own miss. This one's off the mark. Rebound. Big Al up and in.
Yeah, he wanted to make a statement on Ebekwe that time. You know, it might have been better off. It might have been better off to let him have that other one. I think he's fired him up.
Just inside, knocked off his hand by Rich.
Well, you talked about that Virginia Tech game in which Thornton just took over in the second half after going scoreless in the first half. He does have that capacity. He plays very well within himself.
Etchefu rebounds the miss, and those 2 missed free throws by Strawberry at the start of the half, and Maryland trying to play catch up. We got a chance for another 4-point play.
And you know, Swan is kind of amazing. The left-handed shot, when he gets his feet square, he has a beautiful release, but he has a tendency sometimes coming to his right, he does not get squared up in the jumper. Watch it right there. See how his feet were completely squared up to the basket. He's a solid shooter in that position.
A timeout for Maryland as the Terps have fallen behind by 10. Swan's going to the line for another 4-point play opportunity.
NBA, a new generation of players who are driven by one thing, the desire to win. Now that Wade's Heat have a title, will LeBron's Cavs be next? Can the Suns prove that offense wins championships? Will the Clippers turn LA from purple and gold to blue and red? Watch the stories unfold all season long on ESPN.
So, have you been on a lot of blind dates?
Well, this would make one.
Oh, me too. What do you do?
I'm a vet.
I love animals.
Really?
Yeah.
Where are you from?
Michigan, born and raised. Go Blue!
Go Buckeyes!
Interesting how what seemingly is a little thing could be a big thing. Those 2 free throws by Strawberry
kind of shifted the momentum, I think. Maryland was down a little bit. Florida State's taken off.
Yeah, remember, not only did he miss those two, but they had an opportunity to get the offensive rebound, did not get it. Florida State turned right around. And then that block really got Thornton fired up, and he has been on a mission since that time. Swan for the second time, and I don't know if I've seen 2 4-point plays in one game by the same guy. But as I said before, a left-handed shooter, when he goes to his right, sometimes he forces up a shot without getting in balance. But when he's in balance, good-looking stroke, and he has been on a run here of late in terms of his shooting.
And he did it. 2 4-point plays, a 10-2. Florida State run since the start of the second half.
I'd say it's time to get Jones started somehow offensively. Been so quiet.
Strawberry for three.
That's
and
the
running rebound. Toss ahead to Swan to Rich.
Well, we said he could explode. Terrific job by this perimeter team. Douglas, Swan, and Rich really playing well together. This is a very unselfish Florida State team. You know what?
Abekwe foul.
Sometimes you maybe would wish Thornton would be not quite so unselfish, but they give it up. It was a nice fast break opportunity.
These guards are so athletic.
They really are. And they're strong, Bob. One of the things about you can see Rich, see that elevation? I mean, he was almost looking straight at the rim. 6'3", plays a lot bigger.
Etchefu called for that last foul, his third.
These are big free throws for Maryland right now. On the road, not getting any consistency offensively. They've got to get some free throws going. And remember Abekwe as a freshman and sophomore with that very odd-looking shot that he had. He really has worked on his technique, much improved.
Bearing down on 1,000 points in his career. He's 10 away. And has 10 points now in this one. 61-50.
Thornton. Good hands again. In traffic.
Arrow to Florida State.
Now, so far, this perimeter three-guard offense that Florida State has had. Maryland's had no answer for them. They've been able to get just about what they want. Showing a lot of quickness. Look for the jumper.
Thornton. One dribble up in the hoop. Well, that's impressive. Yeah,
well, you know, Abekwe is going to have all kinds of problems with Thornton because Thornton can take him outside. He has range on that jump shot. And then he's got that pump fake and goes by. His time in college has been well spent in regard to developing his all-around game.
And on the drive, Reed picks up another foul.
You know, let's take a look at Thornton as a freshman. You know, he had the red shirt the first year. Freshman, zero starts, 2.8 points, 1.8 rebounds a game. And he comes back, sophomore, 9-1 in points, 4-4 in rebounds. Only shot 54% from the foul line at that time. Now he's the number four foul shooter in the league. Each and every year he's developed a phase of his game that led to improvement. And right now, without question, he could make a case the best player in the league. And one of the best in the country.
He's had three 20-point, 10-rebound games in the conference. 20-10 is very impressive. Do it three times against conference foes. I'm thinking of a former Maryland Terrapin who used to do that. Joe Smith, in his relatively short career, 64 games, averaged 20-10.
Yeah, Joe probably had a better inside game than Thornton, but nowhere near as effective on the outside in the perimeter.
Now we got a hell ball. Arrow to Maryland, and a timeout with 15:53 left.
Here you go, sweetie.
Chocolate pudding, please.
We don't have any.
Ooh.
What is with these people?
I don't know, Duke boy.
We're on campus. College game day, driven by State Farm. Saturdays, 11 a.m. and 8 p.m. Eastern, only on ESPN.
Nothing is impossible. It's a dirty word, a challenge dismissed with a rip and a shred. Gravity is my slave. I don't get air, I take it. I drop jaws, I shake boots, I destroy pipes. I collect precious metals. I don't just land tricks.
No way!
I invent them. Winter X Games 11, it only happens here. January 25th through the 28th, live on ESPN and ABC.
Whether your sport is football, baseball, basketball, it's always a great time of year to be a fan. The easiest way to support your team and find the coolest gear around is online at ESPNShop.com. From clothes to cleats and everything in between. You want it? We've got it. Go to ESPNShop.com to get your gear today or call 1-800-762-1701 for a free catalog.
Wednesday, February 7th, Lost returns at a brand new time, 10, 9 Central.
Go now.
I can't.
Keep running.
Everything you've wanted. 16 new episodes. Everything you've waited for. No repeats. Is coming.
No matter what I try to do, you're gonna die.
Lost returns with a new episode every week beginning February 7th at 10, 9 Central. Only on ABC.
Well, we're watching Al Thornton put on one of his patented second halves. It starts off with a block, but then all of a sudden he said, no, let's try it the second time. Puts it away, right on Ebekwe. And then there's that explosive move, bounce, one dribble and up for the jump shot. He smiles and basically is saying with that smile, there's nobody on this floor that can handle me. You know, he was 11 for 19 against North Carolina with those 29 points, 10 for 16 against Florida. In my estimation, the two best teams in the country, that's what he did.
63-51. Jones. Just off line a bit, and the Noles have it, leading 12.
Surprised with that long timeout. The one guy that's been consistent for Maryland is Gist inside. He's not on the floor right now, and this is a period of time when Maryland sure needs some baskets.
Maryland 1 for 6 in the second half. And another jumper for Florida State, Jason Rich.
I knew they couldn't shoot 60% in the second half like they did the first. They're shooting 70%. Maryland has had no answer defensively for Florida State this entire game. And Gist is coming back into the ballgame now.
Vasquez up and in. Well, he's had an impressive night shooting the basketball.
Yeah, he's a good-looking freshman.
65-54. Thornton pops up to get it. Al for three.
You know, he is so patient. He could have taken the three over at Beckley at the top of the key. Looked and got a better shot. Very unselfish player. There's no question in my mind, with a little bit more of a selfish attitude, the guy could average 35 a game in this league. Not what Leonard Hamilton probably would want, but he is certainly capable of that.
It'd be fun to figure out points per touches for this guy. He's got two more coming on the slam.
I'm going to go back to that block.
Yeah,
you know,
that's right.
Maryland been a lot better off if Ebekwe had let him have the open layup. Because since he had that shot blocked, he has just taken over this ballgame.
And he's destroyed Gary Williams' Terrapins consistently. 27-12 here last year. He had a 16-13 game at Maryland in December of 04. Now the steal and flies in for the impressive dunk.
Well, his shirt had actually been grabbed back in the backcourt, but again, Maryland probably been better off and been called as a foul.
Timeout on the floor, and as the teams discuss strategy, you should too. Get someone to talk with you, not at you. Talk to Chuck Charles Schwab. Well, the Florida State Seminoles have been impressive all night long offensively, but particularly so here at the start of the second half. Billy, we've still got 13:52 left in the half. They've got 70 points on the board.
Well, from the very start of this ball game, and we talked about it in that first half, both teams getting very easy looks. In the second half, when Strawberry missed those two free throws and Maryland's gotten away of getting the ball down to Gist, you can almost feel that Maryland thinks they've got to win it with quick shots from the outside instead of getting that ball to Gist inside. And that's what I'm sure Gary Williams talked to him about during that timeout. Get the big man the ball. That ball was touched.
It was, no basket.
Yep. Jones touched the ball in the cylinder. Offensive basket interference. You'll see it right here. The ball is still in the cylinder. No question he touched it. I don't think the ball would have gone in, do you?
I do not. And you get up there, do you want to? Oh, a turnover here. Strawberry takes it up and in. So Maryland cuts it back to 14. To change things up here. Inside. Oh, the defense evaporated, and Rich got an easy lay-in.
But there's his ability to explode inside. He's a guard down low, but he can get right up around the rim when he catches the ball. Nice pass by Thornton. But no pressure on the ball whatsoever to make that pass difficult.
Strawberry on the wing. Bounce in. And the lay-in is good. Osby with his first field goal tonight. 72-58.
If Maryland goes back and looks at the tape of this ball game, they got an early start getting the ball down and low and getting what they wanted to. All of a sudden, they got away from it. It really has hurt them. There's that explosion by Rich again.
Boy, he is having a night. That's 20, a season high, and two away from a career best. 74-58. You see the points in the paint. Jones, 4-3. That's his first three-point field goal tonight. Seven markers in the game, 13-point spread.
Nice idea against that press to have one guard back behind it so you can make the pass. And here's a turnover, one of the things that we talked about at the top of this game.
Vasquez, and they couldn't touch that one. Or it would have been basket interference again. Mims eludes Vasquez.
I think it might be important to let number 12 touch it.
And they go the other way.
Reed says, well, I see that you're open, but I'm going to pass it to somebody else.
FSU beat Maryland here 71-60 last year. They got 74 points tonight. Al sets a high screen. Mims tries his and bangs it in.
And did you see what happened? Mims beats Vasquez on the dribble, but then nobody comes to help. So once Mims gets inside, he has a wide open shot. I've never seen Maryland break down so easily defensively as they are in this ballgame. And we're talking about a team that's normally a good shot blocking team. There's a case where aggressive shot blocking was in order.
Strawberry driving, dishing. Osby up, off. And a foul on Thornton, his second. And we've come to a timeout in Tallahassee. 10:25, second half. Florida State 76, Maryland 61.
Sunday nights at 8. It's Real Classics. Sunday. Jack Nicklaus. Tiger Woods. Carl Spackler.
It's in the hole!
See Chevy Chase.
Stop thinking. Let things happen. And be the ball.
Bill Murray.
Gunga Galunga.
Rodney Dangerfield.
Let's go while we're young.
And the Gopher. Starring Caddyshack. Real Classics. 8 p.m. Sunday on ESPN Classic.
Get ready to get the games you can't see on TV. Introducing ACCSelect.com, the new way to see your sport.
We've talked a lot tonight about the great Florida State shooting. And prior to this university coming to the ACC, they played in the Metro, and this man lit them up. George McLeod still holds the school record for 10 threes in one game.
10 threes in one game in 1989. Had 115 threes on the year, which is their all-time record. Bobby Sura, their all-time career record from three. But McLeod was a guy, much like we're seeing tonight in Thornton, that could step outside from tremendous range at his size and just bury the shots. Terrific all-around player. And one of the league's, I guess you would really, when you start thinking about it, one of the league's best pure shooters it's ever been around here. Mm-hmm. Although, like you said, it wasn't ACC at that time for him.
Notre Dame wins at Syracuse by 12.
Well, Syracuse has had their trouble, as we mentioned. Can you imagine Drexel beating them in the dome?
Hard to believe. 76-62. I showed you that Wake score, still leading Georgia Tech and Winston-Salem.
Push.
Swans first.
There was Strawberry with some good defense on his part.
Maryland shot 63% in the first half. Terrapins almost being matched point for point by Al Thornton.
Well, again,
the second.
I said they wouldn't shoot 60% in the second half. And you looked at me and said, no, they'll shoot 70. I said, no, you're wrong. They're shooting 80% here in the second half. 80%. Can you imagine that? 12 for 15 so far in the second half. Just a total breakdown by Maryland.
Shredded this defense. Maryland's Strawberry back to get it. Jumper by Gist. Osby up and he's hammered.
Osby doing a pretty good job inside, bullying his way around.
Our Chevrolet Stars of the Week in the conference. Xavier Dowdell from Virginia Tech. Ty Lawson, the Rookie of the Week from North Carolina. For more information, go to lfsports.com. You can read all about it.
Lawson was so outstanding in the Arizona game. Mustafa Shakur, who's an outstanding guard, all Pac-10 player from Arizona, just couldn't handle him. And Lawson took him off the dribble. Did a terrific job, very few turnovers, and just basically took over that game for North Carolina.
And watching that game, Billy, it seemed like if they'd have played another half, North Carolina would have won by 50.
Yeah, one of the things, and I talked about this in that first half, I think that their freshman players had something like about 80% of their scoring. Hmm. Stevenson played, Thompson played extremely well, and of course Lawson, as we mentioned, and with Brandon Wright out of the ball game, Frazier out of the ball game. Kind of amazing how deep that team is.
Vasquez with the foul. Ryan Reed back in for the Seminoles.
And one of the things that the Maryland will start feeling pressure on, Bob, and we talked about this at the top of the show, and I realize we're just at the end of January. But this club has not been to the NCAA tournament for two straight years. Last year, they were the first team in the ACC to be 8-8. and win an ACC tournament game and not get invited. But a game like tonight won't help them at all. It could really give some confidence to this Florida State team, particularly the way they're playing unselfish basketball. A lot of guys having it being a factor on the offensive end.
And a foul going up. The free throw is coming after the Strawberry foul. That's his fourth. When you think about Florida State, Billy, the only home game they've lost is to Clemson. You talked about the great Florida win back in early December, but since conference play, that's really the only one that they stumbled on. They beat a good Virginia Tech team in here and beat them rather handily by 9, shot 57%. They destroyed Miami in here, hit 13 threes that day. Took care of Wake Forest in the second half last weekend, and they've had their way with Maryland tonight.
Well, we talked about Maryland last year, 8-8 in the league. How about Florida State? They were 9-7 in the league, and everybody talked about their weak schedule. But, you know, this year they've played Wisconsin, Boston College, Florida, North Carolina, Pitt. How many people have played that type of competition?
77-62, and too much pressure by Douglas.
Well, he started the game with some hand checking called early, but they haven't had to get that close to a Maryland player. So Douglas picks up his second hand check foul.
Good man trying to make that transition from shooting guard to point guard. Terps 8 of 16 at the line as Hayes steps up.
The number one ACC team in regard to free throw shooting, having an off night in that regard as well. As I mentioned, number three in the nation.
Hayes has not missed. He's 16 of 16. 77-64. You know, there's still a ton of time left in this game.
Well, here's the thing, that if you're Leonard Hamilton, a lot of time in the game, your players would have a sense that this game is put away. You know who better touch the ball the next few times down the floor is Thornton. Don't go away from your horse. He's the one that puts all the pressure on the Maryland defense, and he's going to either be double teamed or he's going to take his man for an easy shot. When he's double teamed, you've got an advantage.
Swan. Reed is open.
Why?
Thornton didn't touch it. Maryland the other way with Hayes. And just an impossible to catch pass. It's going to be out of bounds. Maryland ball. They were lucky to keep it.
Good call there, Bob, because you have guessed, wide open for an easy layup, and the ball was thrown at his ankle. No chance whatsoever him to get down there and get it. A ball up at his eyes, or even up close to the rim, would have been an easy put down.
Shot clock at 27.
Well, after you saw that comeback by Virginia at Clemson, you have a figure Maryland's right in the driver's seat here.
They got them right where they want them. Up off the glass, and we've got an over the back foul coming on Gist. That's his first of the game.
Maryland foul number 15, James Gist.
Hey, you talk about a ball game was over. I mean, Clemson, Virginia, it was 63-49 and under 4 minutes to play.
Nightmare week for Clemson.
Can you imagine? And they're off all week until they get to Georgia Tech on Saturday. Tipped out by Jones.
Well, Rich wanted a foul on the play. There was a little slapping contact right there. I think the official gave a break to Jones.
Reed's in trouble, dribbles out of it. Swan for three. Rebound, Florida State. Reed going up.
Again, Thornton never sees the ball.
On the catch, it's a Jones lay-in.
I tell you, it's time for a timeout for Florida State to say, let me introduce you to the best player on the floor.
Thornton working on a Beckway. Now they get it to him, and a Beckway had to foul him.
That was a good call by Florida State. Let him touch it.
Third foul on a Beckway. The reason you want Florida State to get the ball to this man, he has been unstoppable. 23 for Al Thornton, Knowles by 11.
The Golden Globe winner for Best Drama is Grey's Anatomy.
George has become a sex machine.
And this Thursday.
You yelled at me for no reason, and now you show up here.
With temperatures on the rise.
Anyone seen Callie? I kind of need to find her for something.
Somebody's bound to get burned.
When you get a minute, I'd like to talk about the kissing.
Callie!
And nothing compares to the last 5 minutes, where three of the season's biggest shockers are revealed.
Okay.
An all-new Grey's Anatomy, Thursday at 9, 8 Central, followed by an all-new Men in Trees, only on ABC. Every Saturday night at 8, classic ringside.
I shook up the world!
Studio host Brian Kenny, Bert Sugar, and boxing experts reveal the real story behind the greatest fights.
Down goes Frazier!
And fighters of all time.
We are going to do this one more time.
Next up, Mike Tyson, the Kid Dynamite years.
Tyson didn't know anything. He was raw, he was crude, but he was strong as hell.
Classic Ringside, 8 p.m. Saturday, only on ESPN Classic.
Huskers.
No.
Huskers with a Z? No. Ooh, a husk guy.
Take him.
How about with the heart? Hus, heart, cur. No. Brasky guy, brasky pants, brasky man. Bet nobody's...
Nope.
Somebody's got that. You know what? I need to go write some more, and I'll be back. Oh, wait. Excuse me. How about Nebraska? Sorry, dude. Nebraska.
...77-66, Florida State leads Maryland with 7:34 left, and hanging in the rafters here, wonderful ceremony recently. Hugh Durham, a player and coach here at Florida State, had his number retired.
Number two scoring game ever at Florida State. Hugh Durham had 43 points against Stetson. He took Florida State to the Final Four, beating an ACC team, North Carolina, in the semifinals, and then losing to Bill Walton and undefeated company at UCLA in the finals. And then also took Georgia against an ACC team for the Final Four, where Jimmy Valvano's club beat him in 83. But a great basketball mind as well as player, and a great tribute to retire his jersey.
Hugh Durham's name's all over the record book here at Florida State. Strawberry to the baseline, nice reversal. And Darryl getting Maryland back within 11.
And again, the answer is keep getting the ball to 12 of the Florida State. Put that pressure on Maryland to prove that they can stop it. Wide open is Rich.
And that shot was blocked by Gist. Now Beckway clears, and Maryland can get this thing down to single digits here. Telling you, after what I saw Sunday, Clemson not out of it by a long shot. Well, 6:35 to go.
I think a good idea to get that ball to Beckway and Gist down inside. Vasquez not in the ball game now, had a good first half. Interesting lineup on the floor for Maryland.
Strawberry lost it out of bounds.
Big turnover.
You just get the sense of Maryland's trying to put that finishing kick on, make a last run, see if they can pull this one out of the fire. More Maryland pressure. FSU beats it cleanly. Douglas in the middle. Here's Thornton. The up fake left to Beckway.
Nice.
But Gist with a block. What was on the last time they blocked one in? Gist up and in.
What I liked about that, we talked about Maryland being an excellent shot-blocking team. Beckway and Gist are there. This is the first time we've seen them now coming over and helping from the weak side when guys drive to the basket. With that shot-blocking ability, they should never have uncontested shots inside that paint.
Douglas Swan swing at Thornton. Up and in with the left hand.
Boy, don't you like his determination? He was stopped twice today, but both times the shot got blocked. He came right back and returned it.
And tips it away into the hands of Douglas.
That last shot, a left-handed layup, is the only thing he could do was just to create it at the end of that dribble.
Thornton screens. Douglas
gets it.
Vasquez coming back for Maryland.
Maryland foul number 5, Eric Hayes.
You know, we've seen Swan tonight. We've seen Douglas tonight. We've seen Rich tonight get in traffic. And because of their upper body strength, their ability to explode, they get those shots off.
Douglas with 10.
Turnover by Strawberry going down on the baseline hurt Maryland. Gave Florida State a little bit of breathing room.
Gist missing that three-point attempt, and now Florida State up 14 with the ball.
Thornton's limping a little bit coming down to the floor. Might put a little dribbling exhibition out here at the top of the key, his own little version of four corners.
Shot clock under 10, maybe for the first time tonight. Florida State, Douglas up and off. Rebound Douglas, he scores. Now let's check.
Well, Thornton actually saved himself from a severe fall by grabbing the rim. Officials did not call it and shouldn't have. Watch Thornton come across the lane. He grabs the rim to help himself because he was going right flat on his back.
Right.
And again, the ball was not in the cylinder when he did that.
Timeout, Maryland. 4:19 left.
30-second timeout, Maryland.
Food Lion and Pepsi have teamed up again this year for the Sync One Score a Million sweepstakes. Three contestants will win a trip to the ACC tournament in Tampa. And a chance to take a half-court shot for $1 million. Visit foodline.com for all the details. You mentioned Thornton was limping a bit. The fellas in the truck checked the tape, and this is what we came up with. Look at him as he just stepped on a Beckway's foot there.
Yeah, that's one of those deals that can really create a severely sprained ankle. You saw Williams from Arizona come down on that jump shot over the weekend. You land on it, and he is really limping out there. But give him the ball and let him explode to the basket, he may well be limping.
Yes. Vasquez. And it taken away by Douglas. And he wisely backs it out.
Nice move. In just regard to athleticism, Rich Douglas Swan probably can match up pretty well athletically with any three guards in the league.
Here's Douglas. Here's Rich. The fake.
Oh. And Strawberry was on him, but couldn't contain him.
22 for Jason, ties his career high. This one rolls in for Brown. And a foul as we step aside with 3:16 left. Jason Rich is having a night as well. It hasn't been all Al Thornton. Timeout in Tallahassee.
Gamers, the best of the best.
You want fun, you want some fun.
This elite group hit the road battling each other for the right to stay on the bus.
Let's go, baby!
But in the end, it's the last two standing who will play for $100,000 on the big screen in Times Square. Madden Nation, ESPN2.
This is the legend of Muhammad Ali.
Oh my goodness, it's Muhammad Ali.
Float like a butterfly.
Sting like a bee.
Now available.
I've done something special.
Bring home the greatest on DVD.
I'm a world figure.
I am from the House of Shock.
His life.
Who's the top of the world?
His legend.
History will be written.
His words.
That alternative is justice.
I am American.
I am the greatest.
I'm the champion of the world.
Ali Rapp. DVD and book available now.
A look at our Jeep game summary, 88-72 Florida State. And you look at that shooting number, Florida State has been over 60% all night long. 63 now for the game, 61 in the second half. The all-time FSU record is 73% in one game, 72-7 to be exact, against Minnesota in the 1979-80 season. They were 48 of 66 in that game.
Bob, you made a very astute observation before we went on the air tonight in regard to some of these statistics don't make a lot of sense. And one doesn't make a lot of sense at all. The number one field goal percentage defensive team in the ACC this year is Maryland at 37% holding their opponents. And look at what Florida State has done to them tonight. And it was obvious right off the bat that the intensity by Maryland and the defensive end on the floor was not there.
And that was an open look. On the wing, the layup jam follow for Gist. 21 for James. 88-74. 2:35 to play.
Trying to use some clock is Florida State. If you're Gary Williams, you don't even want to look at the tape of this game.
No.
His guys have given no effort whatsoever defensively.
Strawberry, Gist.
Now there's some effort on the offensive end. Look at this. Nobody even down floor.
Didn't know Rich was back there.
I really have never seen a Gary Williams team give this type of effort on the defensive end of the floor. You can have bad shooting nights. You can have nights when maybe the other team has just shut you down. But as far as the defensive intensity, it was not here.
Minute 25 to play in Florida State. Here's Thornton racehorsing to the basket.
Kind of surprised he took that shot. Minute 20 to go. You got the lead. And there's another steal. Look at the lob.
Nope. Douglas to the line.
I thought he was going to throw the lob to get down in there and just throw it up in the air, let Thornton get about 2 feet over the rim and throw it through. This is a very good win for Florida State.
Illinois, that's a halftime score, 28-17 over Michigan State.
Now that's possible.
Wow.
That is possible. Tom Izzo's club, great comeback against Ohio State last weekend. And they have to come right back and play Ohio State at home this Saturday. I watched the game last night for a few minutes. That was the Kansas-Nebraska game. I didn't think Nebraska was ever going to get to 20 points. They were down something like 46 to 16 at halftime. Thornton goes out.
Standing up and well-deserved. Next up for Florida State, Sunday at Duke. This is an 18-point game. Lay in for Parrish Brown. Timeout Maryland with 107. Maryland goes to Wake Forest Saturday in their next game.
We had Gary Williams over there exploding.
ACC basketball has been brought to you by Food Lion, by Pepsi, by Geico, by Budweiser, by your Carolina Jeep dealer, and by Alltel.
We talked about FSU and their game at Duke this Sunday. Here's the way the rest of it shapes up, Billy. They've got to go back to Clemson, host Boston College and Georgia Tech, go to Virginia, go back to Maryland in the return game, and then host NC State. That's what the next seven look like.
And there's nothing easy in the league.
No.
You know, and but this game really does help them. Not only in the league, but in regard to the RPI.
Season
solid
high
performance.
Points.
Gary Williams took his team during that timeout and just gave him a lacing.
Strawberry just fouled out of the game. How about practice tomorrow, College Park?
This will be a long trip home for this team. And you know, you mentioned Florida State going to play at Duke. Remember last year? Controversial game.
Oh, that's
at
right.
Duke.
Yeah. Red Lobster presents the nothing but net shot of the game. We had not one, but 2 4-point plays turned in by this man. Isaiah Swan in one of the first half gets one here in the second half. We got to check the records on that one.
And in both cases, there was not a Maryland defender within 3 feet of him to get himself in a position to shoot the jump shot. I would think if you're Gary Williams coming off this game and the direction that his team could be headed, you basically say, I have no starters. You're going to have to fight for the job for the next game based on what you do in practice over the next couple of days.
As you look at the trends, they lost at Virginia by 12 and gave up a ton of points in that game. They go to Wake Forest, as we talked about, on Saturday, but now it's 3 losses in their last 4 games. This is a ball club that got off to a terrific start in the pre-conference schedule. We talked about that road win in Illinois. It was so impressive. Beat Michigan State. You know, they had some solid wins early, but it's going sideways on them.
And with freshman guards early and looking at how impressive they were, I thought by this time of the year this was going to be one of the ACC's better clubs.
Strawberry, Milbourne. Strawberry's fouled out. Landon going up and will try it at the line.
So let's see. Jones is the only starter on the floor now for Maryland. He never did get started in this ball game. He's probably going to come out right now.
He got to 9.
You're watching ESPN.
And Mike needed 7 for 1,000, so he accomplished that.
One of the things Gary Williams will be looking at this next ball game, you know, he's sitting on this situation where he can become the third coach in ACC history to win 150 games in the league. It will not happen tonight, however. He gave up 96 points and
This will be the fourth straight home court win in conference play for Florida State. And they'll be 13-1 in this building. Only Clemson has won here. And that includes the Florida Gators, who did not win here December the 3rd.
And speaking of the SEC, of the Gators, two teams that have really been impressive that weren't anticipated, Vanderbilt and Georgia, having really fine seasons.
Pepsi players of the game. James Gist had 23 to lead the Maryland Terrapins tonight. Al missed by two rebounds, another 20-10 effort. '96-'79, Seminoles back it out, dribble out the final seconds of their 16th win of the year. And their third straight over Maryland and Tallahassee. Gary Williams shakes the hand of Leonard Hamilton. Our final score tonight, Florida State 96 and Maryland 79. Coming up this weekend at 1 o'clock, some of you will see Virginia Tech, BC, or Clemson, Georgia Tech. Saturday night, it's Maryland and Wake Forest. For Billy Packer and our entire crew, this is Bob Rathman thanking you for joining us. You've been watching exclusive coverage of ACC basketball on the Raycom and Lincoln Financial Sports Network.
You're watching ESPN Full Court, presented by Olivia High Definition Television. For more info, log on to olivia.com.
Monday.
You can't stop.
Super Tuesday.
Up in the air. Oh, my goodness.
ACC Wednesday.
The Dokies are on fire.
All season long, beginning Monday at 8 on ESPN.
Like that, already down on the field. They get the whole thing going. So every single player from both teams is there. So you got 45, 46 players down there, 47 players, and they're all waiting to be interviewed. Everybody wants to talk to Peyton Manning. Everybody wants to talk to Marvin Harrison, Dwight Freeney, Bob Sanders, Joseph Addai, maybe a little Dominic Rhodes thrown in there. Jeff Saturday's always a good story. You want to talk to him. And so, you know, you pick and choose, you get your guys. And there's always like 8-10 guys nobody ever wants to talk to, because here's what you have for media at Media Day. You got half the people who really know what they're doing. They've got stories they want to get to. They have to talk to Peyton Manning. They have to talk to people like Brian Urlacher or whoever it happens to be. They got to find those people. Then there's the 8 or 10 guys that nobody ever wants to talk to. Now, if you're Peyton Manning, you literally are up on a dais and you're in a covered tent. And there's a microphone with speakers on there, because let's face it, half the people there want to talk to Peyton Manning or the coach Tony Dungy, the popular players. They're like that. So Peyton Manning will have a big platform with a big tent. Marvin Harrison will be up on a platform. He'll have a tent about half the size. You can always tell how important the player is or the coach is by the size of their tent. When you see all these reports coming out over the next couple of days, here's how you know you can gauge, you know, there's a status symbol. You go out to the parking lot, you got your Mercedes, you got your Toyotas, you got your Chevrolets, and it just, you know, there's your status symbols right there on the front of your car. Same thing with Super Bowl Media Day. When you watch all the interviews played back tonight, watch and see, is the guy like Peyton Manning up on a pedestal, so to speak, for lack of a better word, to kind of put it into perspective, and in one single microphone that everybody else has to plug into? Or you're going to see some guys that are popular, but 8 or 10 reporters are just going to gather around them. Maybe they're sitting in one of the seats in the stadium. Maybe they're just standing over on the sideline. And then there's always just 8 or 10 guys that are sitting by themselves up in the stands, waiting patiently for somebody to come and talk to them, waiting patiently for someone to come and ask them a ridiculous question. It never comes. They just sit there. There were a couple of guys from the Bears who had an answer for that today. We're going to get to their story in a moment. There's a little bit of a behind-the-scenes look on what it looks like when you walk in to Media Day. We'll talk more about it in just a second. Right now, you're never more than 10 minutes away from the latest scores. Neil Jackson on duty tonight, and he's got our game night scoreboard.
All right, thanks, Jeff. First, we go to the NBA, the Dallas Mavericks, playing without forward Josh Howard, and he's missing the game for the birth of his first child.
Always was and always will be the best rock and roll ever. Top Tracks.
Pistol shots ring out in a barroom night. Enter Betty Valentine from the upper hall. She sees a bartender in a pool of blood. Cries out, comes the story of the hurricane, the man the authorities came to blame for something that he never done. Put in a prison cell, but one time he could have been the champion of the world. Three bodies lying there, there's Patty. Cops. And so Patty calls the cops, and they arrive on the scene with their red lights flashing in a hot New Jersey night. Meanwhile, far away in another part of town, Reuben Carter and a couple of friends are driving around. Might as well not show up on the street unless you wanna draw the heat. Alfred Bellow had a partner and he had a rap for the cops. Him and other Dexter Bradley were just out prowling around. He said, I saw two men running out who looked like middleweights. Jumped into a white car with out of state plates. Patty Valentine just nodded her head. Cops said, wait a minute, boys, this one's not dead. So they took him to the infirmary. And though this man could hardly see, they told him he could identify the guilty man. Four in the morning in a hall room and in. They took him on flame. Rubens in South America fighting for his name. Well, after Dexter Bradley's still in the robbery game. And the cops are putting the screws to him looking for somebody to blame. Remember that murder that you happened in a bar? Remember you said you saw the getaway car? Thinking like to play ball with the law. Think it might have been that fighter that you saw running at night. Don't forget that you are one. Really?
I'm really not sure. The cop said a poor boy like you can use a break. We've got you for the motel job and you're talking to your friend Bello. You don't want to have to move back to jail, be a nice fellow. You'll be doing society a favor. That son of a bitch is brave and getting braver. We want to put his ass in the stir. We want to pin this triple murder on him. He ain't no gentleman jail. Reuben could take a man out with just one punch, but he never did like to talk about it all that much. It's my work, he'd say, and I do it for pay. And when it's over, just as soon go on my way. Up to some paradise, where the trout streams flow and the air is nice. And ride a horse along the trail. But then they took him to the jailhouse, where they tried to turn a man into a mouse. Had a chance. The judge made Reuben's witnesses drunkards for the slums. To the white folks who watched, he was a revolutionary bum. And to the black folks, he was just a crazy nigger. No one doubted that he pulled the trigger. And though they could not produce the gun, the DA said he was the one who did the deed. And the old Nigeria agreed. Was falsely tried. The crime was murder one. Guess who testified? Bello and Bradley, and they both all they lied. And the newspapers, they all went along for the ride. How can the life of such a man be in the palm of some fool's hand? To see him obviously framed couldn't help but make me feel ashamed to live in a land where justice is again. Criminals in their coats and their ties are free to drink martinis and watch the sunrise. While Reuben sits like Buddha in a 10-foot cell, an innocent man in a living hell. Yes, that's the story of the hurricane, but it won't be over till they clear his name and give him back the time he's done. Put in a prison cell, but one time he could have been the champion of the world. We'll be right back.
you know I've had my share. When my woman left home for a brown-eyed man, but I still don't seem to care.
MP3 player big enough to hold all the rock and roll on top tracks. XM46.
Oh, people, look around you. The signs are everywhere. You've left it for somebody other than you to be the one to care. There's no time to find you now. While your walls are burning and your towers are turning, I'm gonna leave you here and try to get down to the sea somehow. Sisters of the sun are gonna rock me on the water now. Rock me on the water, sister, will you soothe my fever brow? Rock me on the water, I'll get down to the sea. There's a seabird above you, gliding in one place, like Jesus in the sky. We all must do the best we can, and then hang on to that gospel plow. When my life is over, gonna stand before the Father, but the sisters of the Son are gonna rock me on the water.
XM 46. Top Tracks. Time without a word. I think about you, I think about love. Darling, if I live without you, I live without love.
Coast to coast, border to border, on and on.
But eventually I built up a tolerance.
This is Rock and Roll, XM 46. Top Tracks.
Restaurant. China. Always more of a hit at the Parkway Diner. We never knew we could want more than that out of life. Sean and Bender and Eddie would always know how to survive. '75, when they decided the marriage would be at the end of July. Everyone said they were crazy. Brenda, you know that you're much too late.